ओके एम आई क्लियर? सो आई हैव टेकन टू थ्री फील्ड्स, मार्क्स वन इन ए वन, मार्क्स टू इन बी वन एंड टोटल इन सी वन. एम आई क्लियर टू ऑल? ऑल राइट. नाउ व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू डू, आई एम गोइंग टू क्रिएट अ फॉर्मूला इन सेल सी टू. In C2, I have created a formula A2 plus B2. A2 plus B2. And I press the enter key. I get the result 140. I got the result 140. Then what I did, I click on 140. At this right corner, bottom right corner, my mouse pointer get converted to plus shape and I drag it to the desired range and I automatically get all the next possible results. Am I clear up till here? All right. Please, Tushar, you come here. Now, I will show you every formula on every cell and you will notice change in the formula with respect to the cells. I click on the first cell and check the formula bar. The formula is equal to A2 plus B2. Right? When I shift to the next cell, see the formula get changed. A3 plus B3. When I come to the next cell, formula again changes A4 plus B4. And when I came at the last cell, the formula again changes A5 plus B5. So when from one location, I copied the formula to another location, the cell references changes with relative to the cell. जिस सेल में वो कॉपी हुआ उसके अकॉर्डिंग वो फॉर्मूला चेंज हो गया. When we were in cell C2 and we were adding A2 and B2, when I copy the formula on C3, the formula itself changes to A3 and B3. उसने वो वाले सेल रेफरेंसेस एडजस्ट कर लिए A3 और B3. दिस इज फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ रेफरेंसिंग विच इज नोन एज रिलेटिव रेफरेंसिंग. द फर्स्ट रेफरेंसिंग रिलेटिव रेफरेंसिंग. रिलेटिव रेफरेंसिंग फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ सेल रेफरेंसिंग. Just current focus on study only. The cell address changes. Relative to the current cell. As the user copies the formula from one location to another. Got it? Okay, now see. Now again pay attention on the LCD and let me tell you the second type of referencing, I am in cell B7. I am in cell B7 and I type the value 5. I type the value 5 in the cell B7. Okay. Now I click on cell D2. I type the formula equal to C2 plus $B $7. Carefully see the formula which I have typed $B $7. In spreadsheet software, when we apply the dollar sign, dollar symbol before the column or before the row or both, that thing become fixed. That never changes. You may copy the formula to whichever location you want. That particular reference will remain fixed. It will never change. What will change? The cell which is relative. But the reference where you have applied the dollar, it will remain unchanged no matter how many times you have copied the formula. Just see the LCD. I will show you the change here. C2 is 140. 140 plus $B $7. अब डॉलर सिंबल मैंने कॉलम लेटर के पहले भी लगाया, डॉलर सिंबल मैंने रो नंबर के पहले भी लगाया. आई प्रेस द एंटर की, आई गॉट 145. नाउ अगेन क्लिकिंग ऑन दिस सेल, आई कम टू द बॉटम राइट कॉर्नर. माय माउस पॉइंटर चेंजेस टू प्लस सिंबल. इट इज कॉल्ड ऑटो फिल हैंडल. दिस प्लस सिंबल इज नोन एज फिल हैंडल. फिल हैंडल, I drag it. I got the result in the next cells. Up till here, am I clear? I am clicking on cell 145. Carefully see the formula bar. Only the formula bar. You get the formula here. I just point my pencil over there. C2. $B $7. This is relative. जिसके आगे डॉलर नहीं लगा, ना रो पे ना कॉलम पे, that is relative. That is what? Relative. अब डॉलर मैंने कहां लगाया? B7 पे. ठीक है, क्लियर हो गया फॉर्मूला क्या लगा. I move to the next cell. ये सेल कौन सा है? C3. C3 प्लस $B $7. C2 का C3 बन गया, बट द डॉलर रेफरेंस स्टिल इज द सेम. यू डिडंट गेट माय पॉइंट व्हाट आई वांट टू से. हाउ मेनी डिडंट गेट इट. I just write on the blackboard. आप यहाँ देखो, जो सेल मैंने फिक्स कर दिया, that was this $B $7. It was C2 plus $B$7. जहाँ डॉलर लग गया वो फिक्स हो, वो चेंज नहीं. अगले सेल पर जब आए, C2 का चेंज हो गया C3. ये वैसे ही रहा. When we go to the next formula, वो क्या बन गया? When I copy to C5, which thing is changing? The relative cell.
the magnetic cell, which is fixed. This referencing is known as absolute referencing.
The referencing where we apply dollar symbol before row and before column, that is called absolute reference. Absolute reference means where the cell address does not change when the formula is copied from one location to another. The cell reference does not change when the formula is copied from one location to another. When the formula is copied from one location to another. Am I clear to all? So, in absolute reference, dollar symbol is placed before column as well as before row. The dollar symbol is placed before the column as well as before the row. Am I clear to all? In which reference formula will change relative? In which it will remain fixed? Now see the third category. I take value 4 in cell B8. I took value 4 in cell B8. I click in the cell E2, and what I did equal to C2 plus dollar B8. Now carefully see this formula. Dollar is placed only and only before the column. It is not placed before the row. All right. I press the enter key. I got the result 144. 140 plus this 4. 144. I autofill the sum. I get the result 144, 154, so on. I click on cell 144. Check the formula. Equal to C2 plus dollar B8. Right? I come down to the next cell. Dollar C3 plus dollar B9.
I told you where you place the dollar, that will remain fixed. Wo change nahi hogi. Jab tak to dollar dono pe tha, dono fix ho. Jahan marzi formula copy kiya, dono fix ho. Now the scenario has changed. What I have done, I have made one thing relative, one thing absolute. जो एब्सोल्यूट है उस पे चलेंगे. एब्सोल्यूट के पिक्चर वो चेंज नहीं होगा जहां मर्जी फॉर्मूला कॉपी कर. बट द वन विच इज रिलेटिव इट विल कीप ऑन चेंजिंग एज यू विल कॉपी द फॉर्मूला इन द डिफरेंट सेल. चेक द समिटी ना. सो द रेफरेंस इन विच one cell is fixed, one reference is fixed and other one is relative, that is called mixed reference.
the combination of relative and absolute. Third type of referencing, mixed referencing, the combination of relative and absolute. Okay, let me see how much you have understood. The formula in the first cell here, which I have highlighted, equal to C2 plus $B8. Without looking on the formula bar, tell me the formula for the next cell. One, raise your hand. Just raise your hand. Formula for 154, kya banega? Anshya. Equal to C3 plus $B9. Very good. Japji, formula for 176. C4 $B10. Very good. Jia, last 171. C5 $B11. Very good. Very nice. Clear? All right. All right. Now I'm going to show two dialog boxes. And those two dialog boxes are very important. Okay, every time we have question on those two dialog boxes. Insert cells dialog box. Okay. Insert cells dialog box, heading DJ. This is your delete cells dialog box. It has four options. Sorry. Shift cells up. The four options of delete cells dialog box. Shift cells up. Shift cells left. Delete entire row, delete entire column. See the LCD in front of you. I have displayed this dialog box. Shift cells up, shift cells left, delete entire row, delete entire column. And by default, shift cells up option is enabled. If I click on OK, that is the default option which is activated. Right? Am I clear to all?